Today topic is Fleming's Left Hand Rule for Motors. I have made one model for explanation, but I will come back on this model later. First, I will explain the theory. Here I have written three things. One is current, second is magnetic field, third is force for motion. If we have current and magnetic field, then using current and magnetic field, force for motion can be generated. Fleming left hand rule for motors tells us about the directions of current, magnetic field and force for motion. This is my left hand rule. These two are fingers and this is thumb. If I keep my these two fingers and thumb in such a way that all three have 90 degree angle with each other. This also 90 degree, this also 90 degree, this also 90 degree. And if current direction is this, this magnetic field direction is this, then force for motion can be generated and direction for force for motion will be this, in the direction of thumb. That is Fleming left hand rule for motors. Now I will tell the difference between left hand rule, this is my left hand, and right hand rule, this is my right hand. See, in both cases motion direction is same. You see this thumb, same. Similarly this field direction is same, but current directions are different. Here we are giving current flowing in this direction. In this case, in this direction current is generated. That is the difference. This is model of motor. This is only for explanation. It is not working model. These are magnets. In between these magnets, there is a magnetic field. I have shown the direction of magnetic field in this direction. I have shown only two lines, but full area is having magnetic field. This is rotor which will move, and red color you are seeing, this is wire. This is positive terminal, this is negative. So current will flow like this. So in this model, we have current, we have magnetic field, and we have motion. This is my left hand. See, this is field. I have shown field direction is this. This is current direction. I have shown current direction also in this wire. So what will be the direction of motion? Upward. So this wire will come up. I will show. Like this, it will start moving. Earlier it was here, now it has moved upward. Similarly, here current direction is reverse. See, like this. So motion direction will be reverse. So this wire will go down, this wire will come up. When it comes here, then you see as per this law, wire force should be upward side. Upward not possible, it can only rotate, so there will not be any force. So here, force will be upward in this wire downward, it will move. Here force will not be there, it will be upward, but it cannot move, and it will move like this. Today we will close now.